Thank you. think it would be much more exciting if you take a closer look at his writing. It's, for me, Bartók's violin writing is just the most amazing, also how it worked for us, for a piano player. But also what he wants is so clear in his markings. Your tempi are often very, very different from his, and so it is what you play for me is always exciting, but that doesn't help, I find. I find there are so many places where he clearly marks calmo, piano, no crescendi, no espressivi, and you're all the time like this, so we get much more contrast if you look closer, especially at the tempi. So for instance, the second theme, it is just a fraction slower than the ground speed, and we will hear more, and we go through the whole piece. Also, the second... if you... You have in 100, and now in 94... So it's just a notch, a different personality, but it's the same thing. And if you make all the slow things really slow and faster, it becomes a bit arbitrary, yeah? And I would be very much like a professor pointing out that you are changing, like such a nice slur by him. I would never break it. Or different gesture from why change it? And first entrance, so beautifully, so orchestra and in this upbeat he makes. So, here I am. So that is a gesture. Just look very closely at everything. It's beautifully done. And really well played. Can we start at the beginning? Slightly more young than da da da, and now. later, yo. But that's the female side. Oh, yo. And he writes the non-top chord or minor chord. But that's, you say, very lyrical for me. It's a little more the verbunkosh. Kind of know what it means, but I know it's fading out or crumbling or any.
Like
by now, any Italian
like
in the
diamonds.
Audience? Like diamonds, yeah, you don't die at all. It's not something that's so.
Thank you.
So. Yeah, we will guess what it is, but if we make the next entrance much less. Okay, go on. Triple P in the it's about color and maybe getting scared of the big changes because before you are in charge of everything and now really calm down, but it doesn't have to be, it cannot be to a different tempo. Mm-hmm. And I think you should have this learn. Some shape and then we go. Mm-hmm. Der Rohr. Okay. I think the crescendo is. Nochmal. Thank you. you should be the one who's also listening. You're still very active and you do things harmonically, and I think this is just something running its course. And this time not dying, but fading out. Good. And the next, maybe skip the slur in. I know it's a bit more difficult, but it is very obvious. And then... I think if you listen to the brass, they wouldn't all of a sudden play to them long. Not short, but not as possible. That's all very good. Then the next piece plays is a fast place. series. And that's where you're done. I think. Something about, think about vibrato, some notes, and fingering. I think you're doing it. It seems to be so more natural that it's always above. That's going up on the strings and not just from the violinistic. I think this is how he would have figured it out. It works, going up on the strings. But go from here.
Thank you.
guess we are, what's the time?
10 minutes to go.
Ten?
Then we have 10 minutes to go.
Okay, great. Then go from here. Before it is fast, yes, but I think the rhythmic element is important. It's not strong this way, it's so. Mm-hmm. So maybe the same tempo but with vertical ideas. Can you try again?
Sure.
Thank you.
Franz Kamel and shouldn't go into this mode.
Okay.
So, and after a while, this is really with this more bit tone in the right arm. Yeah. Can we go directly from the one?
Yes.
No, bum, 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 bum. One bar before. Sorry? Not yet.
And go home.
Fantastic.